expect to see you here. Yeah, Mordecai, he had to step out, so he asked me to watch shop while he was gone, so I was just taking a look at some of the stuff he's got here, some pretty interesting things. How have you been? You've been all right? You know what? I got this, a second. You like movies, right? That's what I thought. Since you're here, since we're both here, why don't we make the best of this moment and stock. Icelandic toasted porter. And just so you know, these are beers that I personally pick up myself. I'm not here to do any kind of promotion. I'm not paid to do this or anything like that. And just so you and everyone else knows, I still see this, but I have a list of beers, like 30-40, that possibly you and other viewers have submitted when I did a call for beer. Received a lot of suggestions, so just so you know, and just so anyone else out there knows, I haven't forgotten about your suggestions, so I'll be getting to those. it says, with clear notes of toffee and dark chocolate, this porter is roasty and rich, offering a medium body that is robust yet smooth on the palate. Toasted and chocolate malts give it a sinister black color, but it's easy to drink taste. We'll have you believing that there's no more need to be afraid of the dark. And it's got a 6% ABV. It's got a cool little double X little bottle cap. And there's one word on the description that I love: rich. And I like to think that I have a rich life, not financially, but I mean, I love rich music. I love depth, music with depth. That's why I like Tool, Carnival, you know, Metallica, heavy metal. Powerful, rich, emotional. You know, I love chocolate. I love rich food. You know, lobster, rare steak, prime rib, and of course, porters and stouts. They're just, you know, it's rich, and I like coffee, so. And, you know, art, so many, you know, it's just a very, I like to think I'm a very passionate person, rich, and all that, so. But before we get started, we gotta do our exercises. It's real important that we make sure that we always take care of our bodies. So, if you're ready for the exercises, we're going to limber up and loosen up. Alright, so here we go. One. All you gotta do is raise your arms. Two. If you don't feel like raising your arms, you can just think about raising your arms. Four. I might have missed three, but it's okay. Five. I think you're doing great. Six. Seven. You can burn a lot of calories just thinking about doing exercises. Seven. I think almost on seven. Eight. Nine. Almost there. You can do it. One more. One. You can almost. Ten. Good job. Give yourself a round of applause. All right, let's get this puppy opened. And I may, throughout this video, tap on some objects or mess around a little bit. I know quite a few of you enjoy, or the majority of you and everyone else out there, this. So, like I said, I'm going to talk about some movies that I've seen. I'm going to do this movie review, I guess you could say roundup. I'm not going to be able to do a video for every movie, it's just impossible. So often, I will put one of these out. Alright, let's give this a pour. Mm-hmm. nice head. Had a nice head. Say they said here toasted in chocolate malts, toffee in dark chocolate. I would say it has the aroma of a typical porter at this point. Nice, creamy mouth feel, not too much carbonation. It's definitely, I can taste some hint of dark chocolate. Toffee, I would say there's some toffee there. It's not too pronounced. It tastes like a typical porter. I would, you can see there is some carbonation coming to the top. Well, you can't see, I'm sorry, but I don't feel a lot of that. And it's, there's slight bitters, but it's kind of that dark chocolate. Say there's a nice dark chocolate there. It goes down nice and smooth. Like I said, I love a porter, so this, I would definitely drink this. I would buy a case of this easy. This is one of the, I give this 4 stars. This is a good beer. It's not just a good beer. It's not a strong, dark chocolate bitter. It's just a subtle. This is delicious, actually smooth. Everything I think you'd want in a porter. This is great. Definitely would drink this again, so I'm glad I purchased that. That was not a viewer recommendation. I didn't have my list of recommended beers when I went out to pick up a bunch. It was just a spur of the moment. Alright, so, oh my bad, I forgot to cheers. Cling. So, movies. We're gonna talk as I'm not sure if I already said or not, but in the description of this video, find links to IMDb to each movie's page so you can watch the trailers. So I'm going to go over all the movies that I want to see first that are coming out this year. Hopefully I'll be able to see them. And then after, talk about the movies that I have seen in theaters this year or that I've received this year on DVD. From Netflix. So, first movie is Dawn. of the Apes. I'm sure most of you are probably familiar with this. I was a huge fan of the original movies and the TV show. Just love that the TV show's introduction. I remember the sunset with the apes on horseback. That was just a great kind of silhouette shot. I'll never forget that. And that clap and that music too. I didn't see Rise of the Planet of the Apes. I don't know, whatever movie came out prior to Dawn of the Planet of the Apes. I didn't get to see the first one. And I probably should, but I don't think it's going to happen because I still have a DVD here that I got from Netflix like 3 weeks ago that I haven't yet watched. I did see the Mark Wahlberg Planet of the Apes. I don't think that was the one prior to this one. That was okay. I'm not a huge fan of Mark Wahlberg. But, I watched it because it was Planet of the Apes. Gary Oldman is in it. He's the lead actor. I think he might play the scientist. I'm not sure if he was in the previous Planet of the Apes film. Also, most notably, Cody Smith McPhee, who was the boy in the film The Road. So that's kind of cool. I'm not sure what role he plays. And then Andy Serkis as Caesar. And I believe he also played Gollum, if I'm not mistaken. And just a brief synopsis, a growing nation of genetically evolved apes led by Caesar is threatened by a band of human survivors of the devastating virus unleashed a decade earlier. They reach a fragile peace, but it proves short-lived as both sides are brought to the brink of a war that will determine who will emerge as Earth's dominant species. So, definitely looking forward to that. I saw the trailer, just pretty amazing from, what I saw of it. I think it's going to be a great remake. So, love to hear from you if you've seen that movie. Whether it's the first one, I guess Rise of the Planet of the Apes, I'm not sure. A movie that's out now, as of the date of this video, is Maleficent. From Disney Studios with Angelina Jolie as the lead actress who plays Maleficent. And it's the live-action reimagining of Walt Disney's 1959 animated movie, Sleeping Beauty. So I loved Sleeping Beauty, the cartoon. We own the Blu-ray. Definitely looking forward to seeing this. Can't wait. I'm going to try to see it this weekend. This is Friday the 13th, so I'm hoping that Sunday the 15th I'll be able to see that in the theater as a Father's Day present to myself. That's my plan. So definitely let me know if you've seen that and what you think of that. How to Train Your Dragon number 2. The first one was great. Great film for kids, animated, not a cartoon, more of a CGI. So definitely looking forward to number 2. The first one had a lot of heart and a lot of action and it was just great. If you're going to see that or if you've seen it. I'm not sure if it's out yet. Guardians of the Galaxy, based on the same name of the comic book. I'm not sure if it's a series, if it's ever been a series, but it's definitely a group of superheroes, renegade superheroes, so to speak, in the Marvel universe. So that looks pretty interesting, and it has Vin Diesel. I'm not a fan of Vin Diesel, but luckily he's playing a tree, synopsis says, in the far reaches of space, an American pilot named Peter Quill finds himself the object of a manhunt after stealing an orb coveted by the villainous Ronin. So, hopefully that will be a decent film. Sin City, A Dame to Kill. A Dame to Kill For. I had no idea this was coming out, so it was quite a pleasant surprise. It has pretty much the same cast as the first Sin City, and I loved that movie. That movie was just dark and gritty and had a film noir characteristic, and it was just pretty gruesome at some parts, but it's a fantastic film. I saw the trailer for this one, and it looks okay. I'm not sure if it's going to be able to live up to the first one, but I guess we'll see. It has Jessica Alba, Mickey Rourke, Bruce Willis, Lady Gaga, Ray Liotta, Eva Green, Josh Brolin, and Joseph Gordon-Levitt, or Levitt. For some reason, I don't really like him, and I don't know why. It's just kind of weird that I would not. To certain actors, I just don't appeal to me. I don't know what it is. It's purely a physical thing, and maybe somewhat their voice too, but that's just a quirk of mine. So let me know if you plan on wanting to see that, and if you've seen the first Sin City. The Maze Runner. Now, some of these I just happen to, if you go to imdb.com, you will see that there's a list of films coming out this year. I don't know if you just Google 2014 films, you'll get a bunch of websites that will list all the films coming out. So that's what I did, and one of the links took me to IMDb, and one of the films I saw was The Maze Runner. It looks kind of interesting. Not sure if I'll pay to go see it. It's a group of boys with no memories of their past lives must escape a massive maze infested with deadly creatures. And it's like, I don't know if they're in their teens or early 20s. It says boys. And it's a huge, like, stone maze. Like, it's huge. Stories upon stories high. And they have to try to escape. So the trailer looks interesting. Kind of reminds me a little bit of Lord of the Flies, as far as Sally looks like they're trying to survive. And there's some female characters as well. It might appeal to you. I don't know, so I thought I would mention that. The Box Trolls. I believe this is a CGI animated film. It's not a cartoon, that's for sure. I saw a couple of previews when we went to see some movies, some kids' movies. It's a young orphaned boy raised by underground cave-dwelling trash collectors, tries to save his friends from an evil exterminator. It's based on the children's novel called Here Be Monsters by Alan Snow. So, that looks to be an interesting movie. The Box Trolls, I believe they have boxes on their heads, if I'm not mistaken. But it looks quite a unique and interesting film. So again, check out the trailer in the description of the movie page. And let me know if you're interested in seeing that one. A Book of Life. Christmas. It has a Halloween 2014 release. And it says, it's an animated comedy with a unique visual style. The Book of Life is the journey of Manolo, a young man who is torn between fulfilling the expectations of his family and following his heart. Before choosing which path to follow, he embarks on an incredible adventure that spans three fantastical worlds where he must face his greatest fears, rich with a fresh take on pop music favorites. The Book of Life encourages us to celebrate the past while looking forward to the future. So it's quite a colorful, interesting looking CGI animated film. Hopefully it lives up to Guillermo del Toro's reputation. And there's an indie flick coming out called Chrysalis. The synopsis is Joshua and Penelope are survivors of a deadly infection that laid waste to humanity 25 years ago. When they encounter fellow survivor Abira, their lives are forever changed as they fight off the remnants of the infected. So that's a very interesting looking film. I saw the trailer. And it reminds me of The Road. Also looks like it, you know, maybe inspired by The Road, you know, a little bit of The Last of Us, the various, you know, the whole zombie infection genre. So it, I'm not sure. It's an indie film, so I'm not sure if it'll come into the main, the major theaters. But there are independent movie houses called The Ritz. Center City, Philadelphia, near where I live, and they show a lot of indie flicks. I haven't been there in years, so that looks interesting. Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. That was based, of course, you may or may not be familiar, but it's actually based on a comic book that came out back in the 80s. Huge success. It came out with the movies, and the movies back then. Live action, you know, Ninja Turtles, it was pretty good for that time. I know they have a cartoon out now. I'm not sure if it's on Cartoon Network or what. It's not too bad. This movie looks, I like the live action look of the Ninja Turtles, to be honest. It looks interesting. I want to see it because of the mostly because it's the Ninja Turtles, and to see what they've done with it, to see if it's better than what's come out before, you know, for some of the comedy aspects to the Turtles, and hopefully that'll be something worth seeing. So let me know if you're a fan of the comics or the films or whatnot, the cartoons. Another film called Earth to Echo, and it's a sci-fi adventure by Panay Films and Disney Studios, and it says here, it looks like after receiving a bizarre series of encrypted messages, a group of kids embark on an adventure with an alien who needs their help. Now there's some preliminary reviews that say it looks like it might be a copy off of the film that Steven Spielberg put out where the kids find the camera or whatever. What was that called? 35 millimeter or something like that. I forget what was it called? 8M. I forget. Anyway, to me, it reminds me of a modern day E.T. I think it has some, like, a shaky cam POV kind of shots and things like that. Kids have their cell phones, so it's set in modern times, so that looks like a maybe maybe somewhat of a heartwarming movie that might be good for, you know, for everyone. So that looks kind of interesting. I might take our son. We might go and take him to see that. The Grand Budapest Hotel. This has a ton of actors and actresses in it. It seems like quite an interesting film. I don't know if it's still out in the theaters as of the date of this video. Probably missed it. Wanted to see it. Don't think I'm going to be able to, but hopefully I'll rent it on Netflix. So let me know what you think of that, if you're interested or if you've seen it. So that's really it for all the movies that I'm interested in seeing that are coming out this year. There may be some that I've forgotten about. I know The Rock is going to be playing Hercules. That looks interesting. I don't know if I'll pay to see that in the theater, but he fights a giant lion. I don't know, there's all kinds of crazy Greek mythology, I think, in that movie, so I may see that one. I don't know, that's one of those movies where you gotta go to see and you don't have any expectations. And you just go for the big, it's because it's a movie, it's not a film, you know. So, alright, so I'm gonna talk now about the movies that I have seen that I recommend. The first one being, I don't think I mentioned this in a previous video. If I do, I apologize. Winter's Bone. It's an indie drama. It's somewhat dark and gritty. And it says, the synopsis, in this unflinching noir drama, resilient teen Dolly, or Ray Dolly, I forget, goes on the trail of her missing drug-dealing father when his absence jeopardizes the family's safety. Her deadbeat dad has a key court date pending, and Ray is determined that he show up. It stars Jennifer Lawrence, and if you're not familiar with her, she starred in Hunger Games: Catching Fire, and she also played Mystique in both X-Men First Class and X-Men Days of Future Past. And this film won a bunch of awards. I'm not sure when it came out, but it won the 2010 Sundance Film Festival Grand Jury Prize for Drama. It won a bunch of 2011 Independent Spirit Awards. It won 2011 Golden Globe Awards for Best Actress, 2011 Academy Award for Best Supporting Actor, Best Actress nominee, Best Writing Adapted Screenplay nominee, and Best Picture nominee. So it was nominated for the 2011 Academy Awards, but I don't think it won an award. That is a great film. It's a lot of great cinematography. It takes you into a very rural part of America. Into a more, I wouldn't say poor, but less than middle class, I would say. And it's not what you expect. Nice, interesting ending. So, yeah, I would definitely, if you like dramas, if you like stories like I do, and great characters, this is definitely something that I would recommend. I loved it. Okay, I saw X-Men, Days of Future Past, and that was great. Actually, the weekend prior to this video's date of this video. That was a great movie. I'd give it 4 stars. I wouldn't give it 5 because it's a superhero movie, so I can't give a superhero movie 5 stars. It's not quite in the same caliber as a great film, you know, but like The Godfather. But 4 stars for one of the best superhero movies I've seen. You get to see some great stuff with Mystique, Wolverine, of course. I always forget him, and I should know his name, but this isn't quite what it used to be. Hugh Jackman, thank you. And it, of course, what's his name, who plays Professor Xavier? I can't think of his name. Picard. But that's not his real name. And, it has probably some characters from, in the comics, from the future, because I know, I'm pretty sure there were some X-Men future in the comic books. I don't really follow the X-Men comics too much, but anyway, I don't want to go off on a tangent too much, but that was a great film. A great superhero movie. I would say not a film, it's a good movie. All borderline on being a film, because it had some really good story and character elements. It really did, so. But it was really Wolverine-based heavily. Somewhat, you got to see some Mystique. It had, but I liked it, enjoyed it, saw it, and I might watch it again. But yeah, let me know if you've seen that. I thought it was definitely a better than X-Men First Class, I guess, and a great follow-up to it. Ending, and was a lot of great special effects, a lot of cool interaction with the characters and the antagonists, I guess, and the protagonists, you could say. I don't want to give too much away, but with the Sentinels, that was great. How they, some really great scenes with the Sentinels, how they were taking out some of the X-Men, crazy stuff. Alright, so this guy, I'm going to talk about this guy right now. Godzilla. Flat out awesome. But just exceed all expectations. I watched Godzilla growing up in the 70s and Ultraman too, but you know, Godzilla was just such a part of culture. And I remember, I may have seen Matthew Broderick Godzilla. I just remember seeing a Godzilla in the 80s, and there was a helicopter or something involved. I don't know. He was in New York City, I think. It's been a while. But I don't think I was expecting, I don't even know if I knew that this was coming out, this film. I just got wind of it on Facebook, checked out, so thanks whoever I'm friends with on Facebook, whatnot, posting trailers and such. I checked it out and I said, okay, go check it out. And just, when I go to the theater to watch a film, I have no expectations. I don't look at reviews. I don't care what anybody says. I'll on Facebook I may see, you know, people say, oh, this was awesome and stuff, and I just try to scroll past and just take it with a grain of salt. But I was like, okay, let's go see Godzilla. Hopefully it looks pretty good, the trail looks interesting and stuff like that. There wasn't really too much revealed in any of the trailers. spoilers, I'm going to put my hand up while I talk about the spoiler, and then I'll put my hand down when I'm done, because I don't really have a piece of paper that has spoiler on it. Actually, you know what, I could do that real quick. Judgmental like that, but you know, it's kind of, it reminds me of the this is just my opinion. So, anyway, I like this. I like the new this actor that portrays Spider-Man. He seems more down to earth, more real, more serious, more has more heart. A nice little comedic sarcasm. He seems like the perfect fit to play Spider-Man. And Electro was in it. That was great. I guess it was the Hobgoblin, I believe, as well. But I really liked what they did in the movie and how and Hoop and the character. I forget the actor that played. I think it was the Hobgoblin. I forget his name because I like him. And I can't think of his name. I should have wrote it down in whatever movies he was in. Actually, I think the actor that played, the actor that played, I want to say the Hobgoblin, he was actually in, what movie was it? Place Beyond the Pines. So, speaking of Place Beyond the Pines, thanks for whoever out there recommended that great film. I'd give it 4 stars. I wouldn't give it 5. It was a good film. The pace seems a little bit slower for a drama than I normally would have liked. Great plot twist in there. And here's a synopsis from IMDb. A mysterious and mythical motorcycle racer, Luke, played by Ryan Gosling, who I'm a huge fan of, drives out of a traveling carnival globe of death and whizzes through the back streets of a small town in New York, desperately trying to connect with a former lover, Romina, played by Eva Mendes, who recently and secretly gave birth to the stunt rider's son. In an attempt to provide for his new family, Luke quits the carnival life and commits a series of bank robberies aided by his superior riding ability. The stakes rise as Luke is put on a collision course with an ambitious police officer, Avery Cross, played by Bradley Cooper, looking to quickly move up in the ranks in the police department riddled with corruption. The sweeping drama unfolds over 15 years as the sins of the past haunt the present day's lives of two high school boys wrestling with the legacy they've inherited. The only refuge is found in the place beyond the pines. Very good film. I wouldn't own it. Wouldn't watch it again, really. But a lot of art, good story, and like a great plot twist that just was not expecting in it. So, but let me know if you've seen that. And then we're going to talk about The Notebook. Again, another Ryan Gosling film. Beautiful film. It's one, quote, chick flick. I hate that. But I decided I wanted to watch that. And I'm glad I did. I'm not sure if I shed some tears in it. I think I did. A beautiful, beautiful story. And it also stars Rachel McAdams, James Garner, and Gina Rowlands. And the synopsis of that is, in a nursing home, resident Duke reads a romance story for an old woman who has senile dementia with memory loss. In the late 1930s, wealthy 17-year-old Allie Hamilton is spending summer vacation in Seabrook. Local worker Noah Calhoun meets Allie at a carnival, and they soon fall in love with each other. One day, Noah brings Allie to an ancient house that he dreams of buying and restoring, and they make love. But Allie His parents do not approve of their romance, since Noah belongs to another social class, and they travel to New York with her. Noah writes 365 letters to Allie, but her mother, Anne Hamilton, I'm going to skip that. 3 years, some years passed. Okay. It kind of gives away some things, so I won't say too much, but it's a great romantic story. I guess you gotta be in a certain frame set to watch those. I like to watch more dramas and films of this nature anymore. I'm not into horrors too much, thrillers to a degree, action films, yeah, but I like stories with heart. Whether it's romance or a drama, that's just, you know, that's just my bag. So, but that's, I definitely recommend that, The Notebook. Just beautiful. Okay, an old film that I saw in the theater. I believe I saw in the theater. I think I saw it. I think we saw it. Boy, I don't even know if our... Wait a minute. This might have been before the birth of our son. I'm not sure where our son might have been. Anyway, The Girl with a Dragon Tattoo. I don't know when that came out. It might have. I can't honestly remember if I saw it in the theater, if we saw it in the theater or not. If it came out before 2007, when our son was born, then we saw it in the theater. But if it came out after 2007, then we watched it via Netflix. That's a great film. I would own that. I should own that. The reason I haven't watched it again, or I don't own it, is because of the ending. But a great film, along with Let the Right One In, the original Swedish, I think that's a Swedish film. Old Boy, 2003 film out of South Korea. If you've seen that, then you know why I'm smiling, because of the amazing plot twist and ending. Watched this a couple years ago. I had to rewatch it again this year because I just completely forgot that I ever watched it. And after the first half an hour, I was like, wait a minute, this is starting to sound familiar. Oh yeah, I did see this before. But it was, wow, it was so long ago. And it was when I first started to get into indie films that I watched it. I was getting into foreign films. An average man is kidnapped and imprisoned in a shabby cell for 15 years without explanation. He then is released, equipped with money, a cell phone, and expensive clothes. As he strives to explain his imprisonment and get his revenge, Oh Dae-soo soon finds out that his kidnapper has a greater plan for him. Maniacal smile. And is set onto a path of pain and suffering in an attempt to uncover the motive of his mysterious tormentor. So, that is a film worth seeing. You're just gonna, if you've never seen that, please watch it. Please see it if you're open-minded. It's just, it's great. It really is. So that really does it. Again, 4 stars for Einstock. I could drink this every day. Delicious porter. And that is the last of it. Always drink responsibly, please. Once you drink, you start to feel inebriated. Don't keep pushing it. Just stop. Once you come back down, start to come back down, you know, then start drinking again. But once you reach that, you know, I hate to preach. I'm not trying to preach. But that's how I drink. I get the effects of the alcohol, and I stop. One beer is good enough for me anymore at my age. But plus, you don't want to get sick. All right. So I hope you enjoyed this session. I think Mordecai is gonna be coming back anytime soon. So I gotta take care of this, or he's gonna have my head. So you know. thoughts. Let me know what you're interested in seeing. Recommendations you have, I'll add them to my Netflix queue. I definitely recommend it. All right, I gotta go.